COVID-19 was spreading rapidly through the community, we realized quickly that outbreaks were happening from singing. And we became very concerned that singing was a way to spread the virus. We were commissioned by a large nonprofit, and they came and asked us, can you help us answer this question? Are wind instruments as dangerous as singing? Or what can we figure out about playing instruments? Because we are literally trying to save music. We're using three main methods to do this research. The first is fluid visualization. We're using a fluid mechanics technique that shows us where all the air flows are coming from when you're playing an instrument. That information helps us know where to measure the particles coming out of the instrument. So we're making aerosol measurements as well. And then we're also doing computational fluid dynamics modeling to understand where the aerosol goes in a space and how the airflow interacts with the aerosol. So we finished our first phase of the study, and what we found in the study is that wind instruments and singing performances generate aerosol. And so we immediately have tried to investigate, well, how do we reduce the aerosol emissions from these activities?
I was contacted back in the summer by a national organization called CBDNA, College Band Directors National Association, and I was informed that they were going to do a national study here on CU's campus, and Dr. Shelley Miller was going to lead that. Out of that comes the opportunity for us to make music in the fall, meaning that she has helped us establish protocols in place, one of which is the 30-minute rehearsal time, and then for 15 minutes we need to vacate the space to allow the air circulation to happen. Next is the distance we see between the students. So we have 12 feet of distance between every single student around the room. And lastly is the mask wearing. So we do mask wearing while they're playing the wind instruments. And then they have a secondary mask to cover a slit or a hole that's cut into the mask during resting periods or between pieces. Dr. Miller's research has enabled us in this very bizarre time and very bizarre setup to at least gather and create a sense of community within our students to allow them to make music together.